All right, we are going all the way to Colorado and Wyoming because these ladies are killing it in the digital selling realm. They also are growing their VIP groups, and they have different ways to switch it up and get more outside sales even during this time. Ladies, how are you doing?
Awesome. Thank you so much for having us.
Oh, thank you. Josephine, we are super excited. You've already done what? 25,000 in sales just in the first 4 months of the year.
Yeah, I believe I'm over 30.
Awesome job. Okay, so how are you guys hanging in there?
Well, you know, we're all kind of, everyone pivoted during this time to move more online. And, you know, like Tammy and myself and, you know, all the consultants, we really, really love our in-person parties. So we're really focusing on our groups more so than ever. And Rachel, for example, who's the newest consultant within this group, she has the most engaged Facebook group I've ever seen. And so I've been stalking her like crazy. So I wanted Rachel, you know, Rachel, can you kind of share a little bit about how you've grown your group to be like a well-oiled machine?
Absolutely. So I think what's really important to know is everybody that's in my group wants to be there. I never did a loop. I never did one of those add a friend contests. When we get to 1,000, I'll give a prize. Everybody's in my group because they want to be there, that I either met in a party or I've met in person. But I think it's really important to stay away from those things because they just bring in people who don't necessarily want to be there. And then they're just dead weight and they really bring your group down.
So what do you do to encourage the women in your group to invite their friends without saying invite your friends?
Absolutely. I absolutely have a ask your friend or like a referral program. It's right in my welcome post where I say, if you feel safe here, if you love what you're seeing and hearing and learning, please tell other women in your life about this group because then they have the opportunity to have that same safe space that you are enjoying.
And so I've noticed as well, you don't have necessarily the biggest group, but you by far like have the best engagement. Like I said, what are your thoughts on that? Like numbers versus engagement?
Sure. And I think this is really easy. It doesn't really matter if you have a 300 person group or 3000 person group. What you're going to want to look at is how active and engaged your group is. Statistics tell us that about 80% of people in your group are never going to see anything you post, which is kind of depressing. And so if you focus on those 80% of people that are never seeing anything, it's really easy to get like weighed down and be like, oh man, nobody ever engages. So really you want to focus on the 20% who are. Out of the 20%, about 16% of them are occasional lurkers. They'll see your stuff. It kind of comes up in their feed, especially a really active post. But 4% of your group are going to be your active, constant, you know their names, you know their faces, you recognize them when they're posted. You're like, oh yeah, why didn't so-and-so post today? Because you're so used to that same 4% posting, and that's good. So what you want to do is you want to look at your group, and the easiest way to kind of fix those numbers is go through and get rid of any inactive members. So if you see those like dead profiles, just go ahead and delete them. It's not bad. It's called just dropping the dead weight. If you haven't heard from somebody in years and you're like, I don't even know who this person is, it's all right. Delete them. If they wanted to be there, they'll ask to come back in. I also never let any members invite their, like add their friends. I have to approve it because I want to make sure, again, those women want to be in my group.
Awesome. So you'd kind of, you know, encourage consultants not to focus on like the number, like, oh, how many people they have in the group, but more so the engagement. That's great. And I hear you. I have like those same girls, that 4% that's always like Ashley is always there. She's always commenting. And then every now and then someone like pops up. I'm like, where'd you come from? So cool. And then I know a lot of consultants struggle with like, what do I post? And I know like, that's something that I struggle with is, especially if I haven't posted in a while and then a big sale does happen, like I want to post the sale, but I'm like, they haven't heard from me in a while. And now I'm like, sale, sale, sale. So what do you do to kind of combat that and stay present on their mind?
Absolutely. And I hate being in those groups, right? Where it's kind of dead and then all of a sudden it's a sale and you're like, oh, they just want my money. And I don't want my girls to ever feel like that. So I try really hard to post consistently every single day, at least once a day. I try to make 80% of my posts personality, things about me or what's going on in my life or funny memes or just real authentic stuff. Because again, they're getting to know me. They shop with me because they like me. And so it's really, I have to remember that that's why they're there is they want to know more about me. They want to, you know, and so it's personality and purposeful and how to use this, what this is good for, this product is good for. And then only 20% of my stuff is a promotional. So if I know we've got a sale coming up or if I know that something's coming down the pipeline, I try really hard to make sure I'm leading up to that with just other things. This or that posts are really easy and quick to do. Just again, real stuff and just be there and consistent. That's more important than what you're posting is that you're posting consistently.
Got it. Got it. Yeah. I saw you posted about shoes the other day.
Yeah. So I won a Teeks gift card because I've been making masks like crazy. And I was really excited, but it's my first pair. And so I thought, you know what? I'm just going to ask my group. I haven't kind of been in there for a little while. And so I posted what Teeks I should get, and they loved it. I had a ton of responses on which pair fit me best.
And then something else that I've noticed you do, you know, a lot of times at our parties, when we talk about products, we really want women to envision themselves using it with their partners and not so much like me using it with my husband. But I've found that you're really vulnerable in your group as well. And you really like share what's happening in your life. And I respect that. Can you tell us more about that?
Yeah. It's definitely a vulnerable piece. And there's been a lot of times I'm like, oh, should I share this? Because it is me or my situation or my husband or whatever. But I found that it makes me relatable. So when I talk about my husband and I getting in this fight, the women go, oh, she's not just here to talk about sex. Oh, she's not here to say that we should have sex all the time. She's here to be real and authentic. And the fact that there are times that we're not gonna because we're fighting or when this situation in life happens or, you know, whatever. And so I feel like the more that they can look at me and be like, oh, she's a real person that actually wants the best in mind for me, that when something happens and they go, oh, I can go to Rachel because she's gonna help me with this situation, not just sell me a product that may or may not fix what I'm coming to her for.
Awesome. I love it. I love it. Yeah. I just, you come across very authentic, very genuine, and again, vulnerable at times. And I think, like you said, people respect that. Women respect that. So thank you so much, Rachel. So I wanted to kind of pivot a little bit to, so once you've got your group established, okay, and you're doing all these posts and you're staying consistent, what about, you know, if someone's like really, really scared to go live and show sealed with a kiss or show a product, or for our newer consultants who want to go live and feature our products, but don't have those toys in stock. Tammy, I know you had like a great start to your group and how you started to feature different products with different people.
Yeah. So what I started doing was I started screen recording off of YouTube, just consultants that I thought were funny, that I kind of looked up to, and I would just share those videos in my group. But, you know, I'd always give them credit, of course, but just to, you know, make sure that people know that these products are there and that like literally anybody can talk about them. And it just kind of showcases different personalities too. Different people can do our job.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, and again, I think it's nice just to show like for people who are really scared about going live themselves, that they can kind of ease into it a little bit and still feature our products and just highlight other consultants that do a really great job showing it. So I know lately you've been doing more of your own live videos. What kind of pushed you into doing like, okay, I'm going to do my own lives versus just highlighting all my friends?
As my group has grown, I've kind of realized, you know, people need to know that I'm the one running the group, that I'm the consultant in it, you know, that this is my group. So I started doing my own lives and it took a little bit because I'm not one to sit here and kind of talk to myself. That's why I prefer in-home parties. So I started just going live more often. One thing that I decided to do to kind of spice it up was I wore what's it called? Peep show lingerie in one of my lives with a bra, of course, but people loved it. It's the most interaction I've had like on a video. I sold a dozen pieces of lingerie, plus people were hitting me up for other stuff too. So it was pretty awesome. Good feedback on it.
Oh, that's so great. And again, what's like more intimidating than going live, but going live in lingerie.
Right. But a little liquid courage helps.
I'm sure. But, you know, doing that, again, you're catching people's attention. And so I actually stole this idea from Tammy. I stole from Monique McGuire, the late night toy talk. So going live in my group on weeknights at 9 p.m. and featuring one toy. So it's short and it's sweet. And then Tammy was in lingerie, like live in lingerie. And I was like, ooh, late night lingerie sounds fun. I was like, ooh, late night toy talks in lingerie. So I've been featuring lingerie, late night toy talks in lingerie. And that was all thanks to Tammy, getting that belt. And of course, yes, you wear clothes underneath, but it's so hard with our online parties versus in person to showcase the amazing lingerie that we have. Cause they're not here. They're not seeing our beautiful racks. So I think this is, you know, has been a good way and you sold so many pieces. So awesome, Tammy. And then I know, you know, kind of leading more into, you know, new people that are in the business, our social sellers. I know you've got a new social seller on your team. Can you tell us a little bit about what you've been doing to support her and her getting her business going?
So the main thing that I did was I offered to go on her like launch party with Zoom. So I was on there with her just kind of helping her out. I showed toys because she didn't have any toys in stock. And I was just there to kind of support her and help her out if she had questions or if people wanted to see different things.
What a great idea. Again, because of the world we're living in, everything is virtual now and everything's on Zoom. You could have cameos all the time from people everywhere. So what a great way to support new consultants and, you know, being able to jump in and showcase your toys that they may or may not have in stock. What a great idea. Awesome. Okay. Thank you so much, Tammy. Kind of staying on that same boat. Kaylin, you also have a new social seller on your team. What have you been doing to get her going?
Yeah, so I'm a big fan of use the resources corporate provides. So I took the onboarding materials that they came up out with a few months ago and marked them up. What are the things that you need for online selling right now? And went through those with my social seller. I also honed her in on resources because there's so much material out there. She was getting overwhelmed. So we did things like go to the training site and say, just focus on the product of the week and the online selling pages to start with, to get your feet off the ground. And just being focused and, like Tammy said, be there to answer any questions as they go along.
I love it. Yeah. I mean, I don't know about you guys, but I've been like blown away about the amount of training that corporate has been pumping out for us and how like they give us the pictures, they give us the wording, like it's all there for us to consume and put back out to our clients. So good stuff. And Kaylin, I know you as well. You just throughout your Pure Romance journey has gotten you, again, I asked you earlier, but would you consider yourself an introvert?
Oh yeah.
Okay, so for our fellow introverts, Kaylin has grown so much in this business. And again, I think it brings out the best in us. But what are you doing to kind of, again, get outside your shell, get mm-hmm. outside your comfort zone inside your VIP groups?
Yeah, so I had this mindset, kind of like everybody else has talked about, that I just felt like I was just doing all these sales, like, you know, just always talking about products or trying to sell them things. And so I was like, what can I do that's really easy to infuse some use of the group in? So one thing I've started doing is every morning, I post a morning mindset. It's a quick quote, a picture of a quote, found online, some pictures I took myself, just something inspirational and motivational to get people in the right headspace for the morning. It gets, plenty of likes and stuff. And I feel like it's giving my clients some value in addition to the product value I'm giving them.
Awesome. And I have noticed you've been incorporating your family a little bit more into your posts.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that's the beauty, I guess. You can look at it as a positive of being home with your family. I have a 4-year-old daughter who is always really excited to help. She's a helper. But when Cocoa Glow was our product of the week, she saw me taking all these pictures of my legs because I put Cocoa Glow just on one leg, like a lot of us did, for photos. But she wanted to get in on the pictures. One of my preview pictures, it's picture of 4 legs, my 2, her 2, and arrows like with Cocoa Glow, not without Cocoa Glow. So I think it just also makes you feel real to your clients. I think until recently, I'm guessing some of my clients had no idea whether, I was a mom or anything like that. So like Rachel talks about, it just gets more connection.
Yeah, I love it. Awesome. Thank you so much. Good stuff, ladies. Yeah. And I know, it's been a little bit of a struggle for all of us to kind of switch into virtual party mode. And I want to share a little bit about the success that I've been having. And one of the things that I really focus on, or I like to focus on, is creating your brand. So Pure Romance has given us so much material from so many different consultants. You really want to pick and choose what fits you and also alter it to be you. And I really strive for high customer service and what is the experience that they have. As soon as they walk into my parties, usually I'm greeting them, I'm introducing myself, I'm meeting them, and I can really kind of control the environment and the energy. But now we're on Zoom. So there's a couple things that I've done to make that experience from the moment that they get invited into the Facebook event for that party, from the moment that they, were done and I checked them out with their order. One thing I like to do is I have a fun video playing 10 minutes before the party starts, because there's nothing worse than joining a Zoom meeting and it's black and you can't hear anything. You're like, am I in the right place? Like, I've never been to a party before. Like, what's going on? So I have a fun little animation, like, welcome to ladies night. The party will start shortly. And there's little dancing popcorns and stuff like that, playing silly music. I do that the 10 minutes leading up to the start of the party. And then at 7 o'clock, whatever time the party's starting, then I jump on. So I'm one of the first faces that they see, even if the hostess is running a little late, so that I can greet them. I always do a 10 minute buffer. So typically my parties, I would do 30 minutes of mix and mingle, but I have that 10 minute buffer from 7 to 7:10 because either they're early, they're late, or you know, they're right on time. But typically a lot of people are running in, putting the kids down and getting in, you know, just after seven. So giving them that buffer time so that the hostess can connect with her friends as well. During that time, I do a quick game, like Beth Martin's alphabet game is a really fun one. Or if I'm running behind, hey Beth, check, you know, catch up with your girls. I'm just gonna grab a couple more products. and then we're ready to rock. And I just jump right into it. But I really think about, again, trying to eliminate any friction for the party to make it a smooth go. So one thing that I do for all my clients is I bribe them with raffle tickets. Everybody likes to win stuff. And it's, you know, bribe them, you know? So I do multiple posts throughout my party planning in the Facebook event, but I pin one to the top with a couple tasks for them to do. So pre-registering for a party. If you're not using Google Forms yet, I highly recommend you do it. My first party, I was like trying to get their addresses through Zoom. And I'm like, of course it cuts out right when you're getting the number. And you're like, what was it? What was that again? Say it again. You know, that's not professional. It doesn't look good. So getting them pre-registered so I have all their details. I have them send me a friend request. We always say we want our clients to request us so that they're following us. And that opens up the Facebook communication. I have them shoot me a message just like Lucy Heinen does. But I ask them a specific question. I say, you know, tell me your hostess's name. And then what kind of relationship are you in? And I preface that with, I don't honestly care what kind of relationship you're in, but I want to know, is my party full of, you know, of single people? Is it full of long distance marriages? Is it full of same sex, you know, relationships? I want to know so that I can better curve my party towards them. I have them join my group and I ask that they log in on time. I also stole from LaWanda Johnson the catalog scavenger hunt. So they get a preview of the catalog ahead of time. I have them print a wish list. So there's all kinds of things that you can do to bribe them with raffle tickets ahead of time so the party moves smoothly. And then last but not least,
Hold on. What's your last, give us your last, we're running out of time here. Give us your last tip. You guys have done amazing.
Last but not least, again, with those raffle tickets, they can help you up your sales. So typically at parties, I always used a visual representation of the hostess credit. So for every $50 that they spent, they got to come out with a strand of beads to bead their hostess with. And it's kind of hard to do virtual beads. So instead I offer raffle tickets. Every $50 that you spend, you earn a raffle ticket. So wherever they are in their with their original order, I can usually bump them up one more level. And then incentivizing them to shop with me that night as well as the next day for bonus raffle tickets is a great way to get people to shop on the dot.
Awesome. Thank you all. This has been amazing advice. We really appreciate it. We are great advice on authenticity, great advice on I love the toy and lingerie late nights, and just being yourself. So thank you very much. Have a wonderful rest of your night and cheers for Cinco de Mayo.
Yes.
Bye guys.